Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining me. This is Stacey Mancuso with WebSand Solutions, and I'm an implementation lead. I want to welcome you to today's session, Take Social Selling to the Next Level with Dynamics 365 and LinkedIn Sales Navigator. I do want to mention that I do have everyone muted, but if at any time during this session you have a question, please use that Q&A portion of the panel to post those questions, and I will do my very best to field those at the end of our session. So a little bit about us, if you're not totally up to speed with who we are and what we do, we are a Microsoft Dynamics certified partner, and we are also an IT consulting and solutions provider. And we are the largest full service cloud provider for Microsoft Dynamics in Canada. I have a couple of links up here for you. I do encourage you to check out WebSand University, which is our learning management system. In WebSand University, there's tons of content to choose from, which might be relevant for your needs, allows you to learn at your own pace and on a schedule that fits yours. And then lastly here, I have a link for our YouTube channel. There's a whole slew of videos covering a variety of different topics that we offer solutions for. So please just take note of those two addresses and check them out, you know, whenever you have some time. So what is our agenda for today? So first we're off, we're just going to really, talk about what is LinkedIn Sales Navigator. Then I'm going to discuss with you leveraging the feature set that LinkedIn Sales Navigator offers to you. And then lastly, we're going to look at that LinkedIn Sales Navigator and D365 integration. Specifically, they're called the widget and the sync. So a lot of our time today will be spent looking at LinkedIn Sales Navigator and just getting familiar with that solution. So I always like to pop a quick poll in here just to know where my attendees are coming from here. So my first question here is, and I'm going to pop this up for you, sorry. What is your experience with LinkedIn Sales Navigator? So I'm going to give everybody about 30 seconds or so to answer that question for me. It just kind of gives me an idea of where everybody's coming from. So just give that a few more seconds here, and then I will turn off that poll. Alrighty, well, it looks like we have everybody answered, so I'm going to close out that poll, and we're going to move along. So I'm actually just going to jump right into LinkedIn Sales Navigator. So with that, let me just switch my screens here. Alrighty, so here we are in LinkedIn. So to get to LinkedIn Sales Navigator, I have my little option up here. So I'm just going to click that, and that's going to open a new window for me. So in here, you see I'm in LinkedIn Sales Navigator. So first off, what is LinkedIn Sales Navigator? First and foremost, it is a social selling tool that enables you to tap into the incredibly large data that LinkedIn provides to you. This allows you to improve on prospecting, engaging, and that whole sales process. During the time I was getting ready for this webinar, I learned that there are 430 million plus members on LinkedIn and 7 million plus global companies on LinkedIn. So, you know, again, you're just tapping into the data that LinkedIn's already providing to you. I do want to point out to you that LinkedIn and LinkedIn Sales Navigator, they are completely separate platforms, but they are built on that exact same data set. But the LinkedIn Sales Navigator, as you're going to see here, provides you just with some amazing tools. So again, LinkedIn Sales Navigator is going to allow you to tap into the larger network of your connections. It's going to provide you suggestions for getting connections. It's going to provide improved mechanisms for starting conversations with existing and suggested connections that LinkedIn Sales Navigator gives to you. I like to think of this really as giving you an opportunity to do your homework. You're finding ways to communicate and connect with these prospects ahead of time so that you have something to be relatable about. next off here, there's just that transparency through the integration it offers to CRM. So you readily have relevant info pulled from LinkedIn Sales Navigator to your CRM records. And we are going to jump into the CRM environment as well, so I can show you how the data is surfaced in there as well. Lastly, I do want to point out, as we all know, LinkedIn is just a free service. LinkedIn Sales Navigator is not. It is a subscription service. And actually, at the end of this session, I'm going to pull up the web page that shows you what that subscription cost is. And I'm also going to put it in the chat panel for you so you can readily get to that link and check out the information on that. Quickly, just a couple of scenarios I'm just going to throw out there where LinkedIn Sales Navigator really comes in super useful. Say you've been at a trade show, you've met a whole slew of people there, and you import or add all of those leads into your CRM, but you don't know them from Adam. I mean, you've just briefly met them, and you really don't know much about them. So LinkedIn Sales Navigator, that integration into your CRM, is going to provide you with various ways to connect with them and get insight about them and learn more about them, you know, kind of find out the ins and the outs to get that in and make that connection. Another scenario here is just LinkedIn Sales Navigator can be used as a lead base, allowing you to find good leads and find, again, ways to connect with them. I'm going to keep circling back to that whole connection thing because that's really, really what it's about. And that's going to become, you know, more apparent to you as we move through this session today. So now, while you're here, you want to really see more about LinkedIn Sales Navigator. So here, I'm going to kind of give you a tour, let you know what you're seeing here and the different menu options you have and what it's really providing to you. So that's where we're moving into the session of leveraging that feature set of Sales Navigator. So first off here on our home tab here, this is going to, in the center pane, this is called your news feed. This is going to be where you can learn about job changes, anniversaries, shared content, articles, mentioning your suggested and saved leads and accounts. So as we just scroll down here, you're going to see there's just a whole slew of information here and updates about my leads and accounts that I've, you know, saved here in my LinkedIn Sales Navigator. Over to the left here, this is going to allow me to filter my updates. So it's going to filter the details that I'm seeing here in this center pane. So if I click on, and I'm pretty sure nothing's going to come up because I did this a few minutes ago. If I click on job changes, basically the people that I've saved in here as my leads and accounts, there's not showing any job changes. If I go to sales alerts, it's just going to filter the information by some various sales alerts. Lead shares. So this is anything my save leads have actually shared. So that's pretty much what that is all about. On the right-hand side here, this is mostly about me. So this is going to allow me to quickly click on here and share an update to LinkedIn. This is going to give me some information in terms of my social selling index. Here, I have the ability to see who's viewed my profile. Now, this is a function you also have in LinkedIn, but by having the subscription, it's not hidden from you. There's oftentimes that with LinkedIn, people that have viewed your profile, it'll show you that how many, but you can't actually access that. So with the LinkedIn Sales Navigator, you have full access to understand and know who has been viewing your profile. Similarly, down here, this is just going to show me any LinkedIn members or accounts that I've recently visited or viewed, and I can jump to any of those records immediately. And then here, these are just some searches that I recently performed that I can easily just jump to. So up here we go. So the next thing we're going to talk about is our next tab over here, our list tab. So here, my network. This is going to show anybody that I am connected to on LinkedIn. So these are just, you know, there's 689 people I'm connected to on LinkedIn currently. I can easily mark any of these people as a lead, and you'll understand more about what that means here as we progress. But I can see here, you know, out of my 689, I can start saving any of these people as a lead. I can see that out of those 689, 23 of them have changed jobs in the last 90 days. This is the team link. This means just people within my own company. I can tap into their connections to further enhance my relationship with people I'm not currently connected to. over here, you know, one of my one person in my entire network was mentioned in the news in the last 30 days, and the list goes on and on as you scroll over to the left. I'm sorry, to the right there. So that's just tapping into my entire network that I am connected to on LinkedIn personally. Here we have my saved leads. So saved leads, and as you see here, they're saved leads and saved accounts. I just clicked on saved leads to start with. So saved leads are going to be those individuals that I have marked as leads in Sales Navigator. This is going to provide me insight into that this provides me insight without that traditional way of having to be connected to them in LinkedIn. So I might not necessarily be connected to any of these people in LinkedIn, but I have the ability through these different searches that I'm doing to surface these people based on, you know, what my prospecting is looking like and what I'm trying to target. So I can save these people as leads in Sales Navigator. I think it's important to point out that they don't know I'm saving them. It's very private. So I can just come in here and save them as leads. And then this is just going to show me my, you know, the list of people I have saved in here. I was showing you that nudes feed there on that home page. What you do need to understand is that anybody I've saved as a lead or saved as an account, they are going to feed into that news feed, so providing me those real-time updates. There's some pretty cool features in here in terms of, you know, what I can do with these saved leads. I'm just going to scroll down here to member here, Natalie Williams. I have this option to create tags and create notes and send messages to these people. And so I'm just going to show you a little bit about that. Here with Natalie, you see I already put a couple tags on her. I've tagged her as being a decision maker, and I've also tagged her as being involved with marketing. I can come over here and I can add additional tags for her as well. There's a few that come just, you know, generally out of, I call it out of the box with LinkedIn Sales Navigator, but you can always create brand new ones from here should you need to. So what's nice about that is I can come over here to my filters. If you let me scroll back up here for a sec, I can come here to my filters on this left-hand pane, and I can see these are my tags. So if I click on Decision Maker, I can see the two people I've tagged as decision makers. So that's kind of what that allows you to do. It allows you to tag and group people together so that you can, you know, really hone in on what you're looking for. And then I can just click on the X there to remove that filter. So back down here to Natalie's member record. A couple of other things that we can do here is I can open Natalie's record. I can click on those ellipses there and click on View Profile. Similarly, I could just click on her name. So we're going to click on View Profile. This will bring up Natalie's profile for me. You can see over here that those tags are indicated here as well. I can always add more from here. Here I can add notes about Natalie. So here I've just put in Natalie creates phenomenal presentations. And then from here I can also see how many messages I've sent to her. And if I want to send her an additional message directly from LinkedIn Sales Navigator, I can easily do that from here. What's pretty interesting is that with the sync that you can do back to CRM, you can actually push these notes and messages into the record if you've actually have them as a record in your CRM. So I can just quickly show you what that looks like. So if I click here, what's pretty cool is I can click here, and since you see here based on these little tags up here, I can see that she's already in my CRM. If I click on View in CRM, it's going to pull up Natalie's record for me in my CRM environment. So here, Natalie Williams contact. If I come here and I click on activities, give us a sec here. If I click on activities, you can see here message from Sales Navigator. So a message that I sent from Sales Navigator is going to show up in here. Similarly, that note that I told you I created, it's also going to show up in here. And what's really awesome about this is I'm a huge proponent of using the social pane in CRM because it gives everybody insight in your organization that might be working with Natalie in this case, you know, what has been going on with her. So that's where that social pane really comes in handy. And it's pretty fantastic that with that sync, we can surface that information directly from LinkedIn Sales Navigator into her CRM record. So let's jump back here to LinkedIn. And we are going to go back here to my save leads again. A really nice feature also that's offered is if I scroll back down here again to Miss Natalie, I have the option to say view similar. What that means is that it's going to show me other people within LinkedIn, not people that I'm connected to, other individuals on LinkedIn that are similar to Natalie. So here I can say, hey, Kalita, she looks like somebody I might want to connect with. I can just save her as a lead. Emily here, oh, she looks like maybe I want to connect with her, save her as a lead. Again, totally private, other than the fact that maybe if they're on this webinar today, they might know that I just did that. But short of that, it's a very private thing. I'm just saving them as leads. I'm going to get information about them in terms of, you know, job changes or articles that they're, you know, posting about or updates that they're doing, just helping me learn more about them. So that's what that whole save as lead action is doing. I'm going to quickly jump over here to saved accounts. It's the exact same thing as the save leads. So saved accounts, this is just going to show accounts that I've recently saved. What's really nice is I can come over here and say, hey, maybe I want to connect with some people in this particular company. So if I click on that company name, it's going to bring them up and it's going to show me some individuals within that company that maybe I want to connect with. So I can say, hey, I want to save this person as a lead. I want to save this person as a lead. And maybe even, you know, David over here. So these are all individuals associated to that account that maybe now I want to get updates about so that maybe in the future I might want to connect with them on a prospecting opportunity. Similar to what I showed you with the actual members or the people, I can add notes about these companies. I can add tags. So, you know, very similar to what I showed you with the leads. And again, just like I was able to show you, I was able to surface other people like Natalie, I can do the same thing with accounts. So here I can say, hey, I want to view companies that are similar to Sodexo. So here, if I click on that, it's going to show me all of these companies that are similar and I can save them. So now these are going to show up in my saved accounts when I come back here. So now you see these are the two new companies that I just added. So that's just another really great way for you to make all these connections and find like companies and like leads and show you ways that you can reach out to them. All right, so the next thing I'm going to jump over here is our Discover tab. So here, this is going to provide me recommended accounts and recommended leads. And this is basically a customizable search tool that allows you to drill down to a demographic that you want to target. So these recommended leads and accounts are being fed to me by LinkedIn Sales Navigator based on sales preferences that I'm sending. And quite frankly, it starts to learn from your behaviors and starts giving you more and more leads and accounts that you might want to start prospecting. I want to let you know that when you initially set up your LinkedIn Sales Navigator, you do set up those sales preferences, but if you need to modify them at any time, you know, tinker with them at all, you have that ability to do that from here. So I'm just going to quickly show you that. You click on Edit Your Sales Preferences, and you're going to see this window that comes up, and I'm just going to scroll down here just so you can get a little bit more detail here. So here you can see I've set up my geography to be all of these. Say I wanted to knock out Memphis. I just unclick that, so that's not going to be part of my sales preferences anymore. I can toggle it back on should I want to. If I want to add some more, maybe I want to, you know, go really international here, and I'm going to say I want to check out Australia. So here on Australia, you see it's grayed out. I just click on the plus and I click done, and Australia gets added in there. Similarly with industry, company size, function, seniority level, I have that same ability here to add more, you know, as many as I need here, and click on done, and then it just adds them to my list. Maybe I want to add some additional company sizes here. So anything that's grayed out is what's not currently being filtered on. So we can add some additional filters in there. So now when LinkedIn Sales Navigator is giving me recommended leads and accounts, it's going to take these preferences that I'm setting up into account. So It's just a really pretty fantastic tool that, again, is just learning from your behaviors and learning from what you want and what you need. So in addition to this customizable search tool where you can really target that demographic, you do have this advanced find or search tool up here. If you click in here, it's actually pretty cool. They give you lots of different suggestions of, you know, things that are readily available to you that you could just quickly click on and it will give you some suggestions. You can also come up here and click on advanced and search for leads or search for accounts. I'm just going to click on search for leads. So from here, I can say, hey, I want to actually apply my previous sales preferences, and it's going to pull in, if we let it refresh here, it's going to pull in, you know, all of that demographic that we were just looking at. Or I can just turn that off and say, hey, no, I just want to start a completely clean and fresh advanced search, you know, regardless of what my sales preferences are. I just want to just have everything under the sun that I want to look at. So, hey, let's just put in some information here. I'm going to say education. And I'm going to put in for my geography, Montreal, and we'll just select that. And then for the title, I'm going to say, and if as you see here, as you start typing, it'll start pulling up suggestions for you about what it thinks you want. So here I can see, based on these criteria that I've put in, I have about 1,800 results. So I can click on search, and it's going to pull up all 1,800 for me. I can continue to filter that down if that seems mildly overwhelming. Again, like I showed you before, you can click on Save as Lead. And again, this will just put them into this lead list for me. If I think this is a pretty fantastic advanced search that I think I might want to hold on to and use later, I can click on Save Search. And I can say, you know, Montreal education, for instance. And I can ask for alerts to be set up weekly, monthly, never, daily. So I'm going to leave it as weekly. Click on my check mark there and then exit. So now I have, you know, created that advanced search, and I can, you know, start tapping into these if that, you know, if that is what works for me. So now I think I want to jump into looking at that Sales Navigator Dynamics 365 integration. So we're going to come over here to my Dynamics 365 environment, and we are going to go to the lead entity, and we're going to pull up a lead that I have in here, Anne. So the Sales Navigator widget for CRM, let me just scroll down here. I'm going to condense this a little bit to save on some real estate here. And if we come down my page here, you will quickly see this, the widget that comes in here. So it's going to give me a member profile, and then it's going to give me, let me click on the match there. It's going to give me the account profile. So let's come back up here for a moment, and I just want to speak to you about what this widget is. So the Sales Navigator widget is going to allow me to work within this single application, CRM or D365, gathering key details about this individual to really enhance that sales process, making the experience more engaging for both me and for Anne in this case, because it's allowing me to know Anne better and know, you know, maybe how her and I can communicate. I do want to point out that this widget sits on top of CRM. This data does not live in CRM. So if I, you know, uninstall this widget out of my D365 environment, all of this information is going to go away. So it's just kind of sitting here. I do want to mention, I did tell you earlier about those activities that sync. So those are going to be shown in your activity pane. So again, you have this member profile and you have the company profile down below, which I showed you. So again, this is just kind of embedded on my form. And as you're going to notice here, this information is going to be the same information that I'm going to see in LinkedIn Sales Navigator. So it's just surfacing that information here in my CRM. So I can readily look at this information while I'm, you know, trying to work through this sales process with Anne. So some of the great features here are these three different tabs. So icebreakers. Icebreakers are going to basically, they're going to display highlights, some commonalities that Anne and I share. It's going to show me recent activity, maybe job changes, published or shared articles that Anne's promoted, any news mentions. And this is really going to help with my as like conversation starters. It's going to identify commonalities between me and my prospect to really just begin like have an icebreaker. So here's some highlights. These are some people that I have some shared connections with. These are people that are connected with Anne that maybe, you know, can be a good conversation starter for me. This is showing me that Anne and I are both in a mutual group, the MSFT Dynamics 365 and also Microsoft Office 365. As I come down here, this is just showing me some articles or some activity for Anne. So she shared some articles here. And if I clicked on View All Activity, that's actually going to take me out to the LinkedIn Sales Navigator site. Let me come back up here. So here, that's the icebreakers tab, just giving me opportunities for commonalities between Anne and I to start off that conversation. Next up here, get introduced. As I hover over these people, it's showing me how I'm connected to them and that they are actually connected to Anne and they could provide an introduction for us. So as I hover over these people, it's bringing up that information and showing me how I'm connected to them. So if I click here on Andrew, let me zip back there. I meant to hover over him and then click on Ask for Introduction. So if I click on Ask for Introduction, it's going to readily pull up a message for me directly to Andrew. And here I can just type in a message and say, hey, Andrew, you know, can you help me out here? I'm trying to connect with Anne. Can you, you know, maybe give me that introduction? You see here I have the ability to copy message to CRM. So if I do that, this is actually going to copy this message to Andrew's record in my CRM as he is a contact. Alrighty, so let's go back here and I accidentally closed out of my lead record there for Anne. So let's just jump back to her real quick. So coming back down. So that was the Get Introduced tab. So again, that's just allowing somebody else to give me that introduction and then related leads. So this is going to identify other people at her company that maybe I want to connect with. They might be part of the process and maybe I want to reach out to them. So if I click on Save as Lead, I want to point out this is not saving them as a lead in my CRM. It is saving them as a lead in that section I showed you in Sales Navigator. So if I clicked on Brad here and clicked on Save as Lead, he would then show up in my my save leads there in Sales Navigator. Quickly going to run down here to the account. Does not want to seem to stick today, but here, this is going to pull up the LinkedIn company profile for me. So similar to what we were looking at in the member profile, excuse me. I do have some recommended leads here. So these are other people at Click Dimensions maybe I want to connect with, save them as leads, connections. These are some connections that I might have that could, you know, maybe give me some information here about the company and maybe, you know, maybe people I want to connect with. And then news. This is just going to be news published by Click Dimensions on LinkedIn that, again, conversation starters. It's giving me a way to break through with them. All right. So next up here, we're going to talk about the CRM sync. So again, that's allowing you to push account and lead records that your team is actively working on from CRM to Sales Navigator. Basically, that push is taking the data from your CRM and making further recommendations for new prospects. As I mentioned, LinkedIn Sales Navigator learns from your behavior. So when those accounts and leads are pushed, it's giving you some more recommendations. It's your choice whether you want to enable that sync. I'm going to show you what that looks like and where that is here. So in here, in my admin, you do need to be an admin on LinkedIn Sales Navigator to have this functionality. So under admin settings here, you see you can just jump to these, but I can readily see it here. So here in my CRM settings, I'm going to click on change so that you can see this more clearly. So here you have your CRM settings and some various options here. So you can turn these options on or off. So the first one here, auto sync, your seat holders. That's going to basically allow accounts and leads from your CRM to be automatically imported to Sales Navigator. And this is going to apply for all LinkedIn Sales Navigator seat holders. So any LinkedIn Sales Navigator seat holders, whatever leads and accounts that they currently own in CRM, can get pushed into LinkedIn Sales Navigator, thereby providing additional recommended leads and additional recommended accounts that you can start tracking here. The next item up here is, at what stage does your sales team consider an opportunity to enter your pipeline? This is going to allow you to choose, again, that stage where CRM will automatically push accounts and leads to Sales Navigator. This is a little bit different, I think, in that it only will take into account seat holders in Sales Navigator, all leads and accounts from CRM will push in here, but it's really contingent upon whether they're a seat holder, you know. So if they're not a seat holder, they're obviously not going to have access, but others in the organization would. Lastly here, where do you store values for your one opportunity? This is just going to help Sales Navigator understand and profile what your largest deals are, so similar accounts can be recommended to you. So that's what that's doing there for you. It's, again, learning from your behaviors. Again, now down here at the bottom, enabling Sales Navigator to sync back to your CRM. Really, the only thing that's going from Sales Navigator back to your CRM would be more of these activity items. So in mails, messages, notes, and again, these are all posting into your social pane, as I showed you previously with Natalie's CRM record. We saw that in the activities tab and the notes tab, information from Sales Navigator pushed into her CRM record. So again, I want to make sure that we understand that, you know, if you have a lead in CRM, any contact information about her in LinkedIn is not going to push in and override information or update information. The only thing that's really pushing from Navigator to CRM are like these activities. So that's really kind of taking me here to the end of our session. I do want to point out a couple of really awesome features, though, that you might want to consider if you're going to, consider Sales Navigator. You can enable some features in here called Team Link. I briefly mentioned that earlier. So Team Link is basically utilizing the power of your entire team's network to help you find the best path to a lead. So what that means is that if whatever Sales Navigator seat holders you have, you can basically tap in to their connections. Even if you're not connected to them, you can tap into them and kind of form that relationship and use your team members as a link, essentially. And then Point Drive here. Point Drive is going to allow you to package and share content with your prospects. You can attach multiple items such as videos and documents to a Point Drive presentation. And then you can also share these presentations amongst your team members so that everybody's kind of on the same page and doing the same thing. And that is actually accessed through up here. You can actually go to Point Drive, and that's where you can create all sorts of presentations and share them out with the rest of your team. So with that, the last thing I mentioned to you is I do want to share with you that pricing information. So in here, this is a link, and I'm actually, if you bear with me here, I'm going to try and pop this link into the chat panel. So I'm going to share with the whole audience. And gonna send that out there. So here, this link that I put in that chat panel, everybody should be able to access it now and get to the page that I am on, so that, you know, just a point of ease of reference. These are the different Sales Navigator plans that are available to you. You can see there's annual plans here and monthly plans. I do want to point out that CRM sync that I was mentioning to you, it's available with the team and the enterprise. It's not available with the professional. So just keep that in mind. I know that's been kind of a slipping point with some people. They don't realize that they actually need that team account. So as you scroll down here, you're just going to see all of the features that these different plans afford to you. Alrighty, so that really kind of takes me to the end of our session here. Let me just jump back here. And the last thing I always like to do is always pop up a last poll question here. So let me get here to my polls. So my question to you really is, do you see LinkedIn Sales Navigator as a value add for your sales team? So if you could just take a moment, to answer that, I think it provides some great functionality, and, depending on how large your organization is, that ability to, use other team members as a connection really could be super valuable. Alrighty, so it looks like everybody has answered my question, which is awesome. It looks like there's some interest there, so that's great. So I'm just going to, thank you for your time today. I'm looking to see if I have any questions that came up, so just bear with me here for a sec. It does not appear right now that anybody has any questions. I do have an email address here, info@websand.com. So if you do come up with some questions or you have any feedback for me or for WebSan, please, reach out at info@websan.com. And I truly appreciate your participation in the session today, and I bid you a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.